are going to start with the very first chapter, that is rational numbers. Before understanding what is rational numbers, we will understand few of the topics. First, what are natural numbers? Natural numbers are just the counting numbers starting from 1, 2, 3 and then going on. Then what are whole numbers? Whole numbers are natural numbers including 0. So whole number starts from 0 and extends. Then what are integers? Integers are set of negative numbers, 0 and all the positive numbers. That is, if you say minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on, extending further. Okay, now we will understand what are rational numbers. Rational number. Rational number is any number in the form P upon Q, where your Q should not be equal to 0 and your P and Q both should be integers. Okay. For example, minus 9 upon 4, as 9 and 4 both are integers, so this is a rational number. Also, if you say 0 upon 1 or 0 upon any number, 0 upon 3, so it is equals to 0, so it is said that 0 is also a rational number. But if you write 3 upon 0, then this is not a rational number because this doesn't satisfy this criteria. Okay, understand what are positive rational numbers? Positive rational numbers and what are negative rational numbers? Positive rational numbers are the rational numbers that is whose numerator and denominator both have same sign. For example, if you take 9 upon 2, here both the numerator and denominator both are positive. So this is a positive rational number. Or you can say minus 3 upon minus 4, as both are same sign, then minus minus cancel out each other, so this becomes 3 upon 4 and again this is a positive rational number. And what are negative rational numbers? Negative rational numbers are the rational numbers whose numerator and denominator both have different sign. For example, minus 9 upon 2, then minus 3 upon 4, or you can say 9 upon minus 4. Here numerator has negative sign and denominator has positive sign. Here again numerator has negative and denominator has positive sign, and here denominator is negative. So in all the three examples we have numerator and denominator both has different sign, so it is a negative rational number. Okay, now we will understand what is the absolute value or you can say modulus value of a rational number. So absolute value or modulus value of a rational number is the numerical value of the rational number without its sign. So what does it mean? So absolute value of, suppose, minus 3 upon 4, so it will be, its symbol is modulus, inside the modulus minus 3 upon 4. So it is just the numeric value irrespective of its sign. So negative sign won't come. So minus 3 upon 4. So by looking at this you can say absolute value of a rational number is never negative. That it is non-negative always. Now we start with the first exercise. The first question is add, and two rational numbers are given. So while adding the rational number, the first rule is to see the denominator. If the denominator is negative, we have to make it positive by shifting its sign to the numerator. So here we will do 7 upon minus 25 plus 11 upon minus 25 is given. So we will take the negative sign above. See, minus 7 upon 25, and here plus minus will come here, so it will become minus 11 upon 25. Then minus 7 upon 25, and here we will open the bracket, so plus minus is minus, so minus 11 upon 25. Now as you can see, the denominators are same, so we can just add the numerators. Okay, so minus 7 minus 11 upon 25, so minus minus plus, so 11 plus 7 is 18, 18 upon 25, and sign of greater number, so minus sign. So this will be your final answer. Okay, now the second question is simplified. Here I am not doing all the sums, rest of the sums you have to do by your own. Okay, now the B question. Here as you can see, 7 and 5 both are different numbers, and the denominators are not same, so we will take their LCM. As you can see, 7 and 5 both are prime numbers, so their product will be their LCM. So we can get minus 5 multiply by 5 upon 7 multiply by 5, and here minus sign is there in the denominator, so we will take here above, so plus minus is minus, and then 4 multiply by 7, and here 5 multiply by 7. Okay, so we get 5 5 is 25, then 7 5 is 35, then 4 8s are 4 7s are 28, and 5 7s are 35. Then minus minus is plus, so we will add both the numbers. 8 plus 5 is 13, and then 53. 53 upon 35 will be your final answer. Okay, now the D question. Here what you can see, minus 7, so it will be minus 7 upon 1, so here the denominator is 1, and here the denominator is 13, so we will equalize the denominator. Minus 7 multiply by 13 upon 13, 1 multiply by 13 is 13 only, and then here 4 upon 13, so 13 7s is 91, so minus 91 plus 4 upon 13, so minus plus is minus, so 91 minus 4 is 87, and negative sign of greater number, and 13. So this will be your final answer. The third question is, find the following sums and express the answer as mixed fraction. So we have to convert the final answer into mixed fraction. Here the B sum is there. So here as you can see, both the denominators are already same. So we will just add the numerators. 25 plus minus is minus 11 upon 4. And 25 minus 11 is 14 upon 4. As you can see, 14 and 4 both are divisible by 2, so we will divide it by 2, so we get 7 upon 2, and when we divide 7 by 2, we get 3 as quotient and 1 as remainder. So your final answer, that is in mixed fraction, will be 3 integer 1 upon 2. Okay, now the D question. Here 9 upon 10 plus minus 46 upon 5. As you can see, denominators are not equal, so we can easily multiply 5 by 2 to get denominator as 10. Okay, so this will be same, 9 upon 10 plus minus is minus, 46 multiply by 2, and here 5 multiply by 2, so we get 9 upon 10 minus 46 multiply by 2 is 92 upon 10, so that will become 9 minus 92 upon 10, so we get 83 minus sign, negative sign, minus 83 upon 10. And now we have to convert this into mixed fraction. So when 83 is divided by 10, so we get 8 as quotient and 3 as remainder, so that will be minus 8 integer 3 upon 10. This will be your final answer. Now we will study the properties of addition of a rational number. The first property is closure property. What does it say? if we add any two rational numbers, for example p upon q and r upon s, then their addition will also be a rational number. Okay, commutative property, it says that any two rational numbers, by adding them, the orders doesn't matter. That is, they can be added in any order. So if we take p upon q plus r upon s, two rational numbers, and they are added, then addition of r upon s plus p upon q is also the same. That is, it can be added in any order. Okay. Now the associative property, it says that any three rational numbers can be added in any order. So if we take p upon q, r upon s, and say u upon v. Okay. So if we first add the two rational numbers together and then we add it to the third number, it will be same as if we add second and third rational number first and then add its answer to the first rational number, it will be the same. That is, order doesn't matter. Okay, now we will see the next two properties, fourth and fifth property. Fourth property is existence of identity. So what does identity mean? Identity means similar, or you can say same. So if we have any rational number, say p upon q, and we add it to some number so as to get the same rational number, that is, if we add p upon q to something, we get again p upon q. So that number is said to be additive identity. Okay, so when p upon q plus 0, so here 0 is your additive identity, so we get p upon q plus 0 equals to p upon q, or you can say 0 plus p upon q is again same as p upon q. Okay, the last property is existence of additive inverse. So now what is inverse? Inverse means opposite number. Okay, so if we add, so if we take any rational number, say p upon q, and we add something to it so as to get the additive identity, that is, this required number, that is the required rational number, will be additive inverse of the first number. So when p upon q is added with minus p upon q, the answer we get as 0. So minus p upon q is said to be additive inverse of p upon q. Okay, now we will start with the second exercise. Now we start with the second exercise. Verify the commutative property of addition for the rational numbers. Okay, so the first question is minus 2 upon minus 3 and minus 5 upon 5. Minus 1 upon 5, sorry. So commutative property, what is commutative property? Is p upon q plus r upon s is same as r upon s plus p upon q. Okay, so we will take this LHS and then RHS and we will prove that both are same. Okay, so first we will take LHS. LHS equals to minus 2 upon minus 3 plus minus 1 upon 5. Okay, so minus minus, both this signs cancels off. So 2 upon 3 plus minus is minus 1 upon 5. And now here, as the denominators are not equal, we will equalize it. So 5, 2 multiplied by 5, here we will multiply both the numerator and denominator by 5. So we get 2 5 is 10, I am doing directly, and 3 5 is 15 minus 3 upon 3 5 are 15. Okay, so 10 minus 3 is 7 upon 15. This is your final answer for the LHS. Now we will solve for RHS. What will be the RHS? Minus 1 upon 5 plus this number, minus 2 upon minus 3. Here again minus minus goes off. So we are left with minus 1 upon 5 plus 2 upon 3. Okay, now we will equate the denominators. So here वन मल्टीप्लाई बाय थ्री क्रॉस मल्टीप्लिकेशन माइनस थ्री एंड थ्री फाइव इज 15 यर टू फाइव इज 10 अपॉन 15 ओके. सो नाउ द डिनोमिनेटर इज इक्वल वी विल ऐड द न्यूमरेटर्स माइनस प्लस इज माइनस सो 3 माइनस 10 इज 7 एंड साइन ऑफ ग्रेटर नंबर एंड डिनोमिनेटर इज सेम. सो हियर यू गॉट 7 अपॉन 15 एंड हियर अगेन यू गॉट 7 अपॉन 15 देयरफॉर LH is equals to RH is, hence your commutative property is verified. Hence the verification. Now the second question, verify that A plus B plus C equals to B plus C and plus A. That is, we have to verify the associative property. Here the three values are given. So we will first take the LHS. LHS equals to A plus B plus C. So that is, in the bracket we will add the first and second number. A plus 3 upon 4 plus C is 5 upon 7. Okay. So here we have to first equate the denominators. Here 2 is there, so we will multiply it by 2 to get 4. So minus 2 upon 4 plus 3 upon 4 and here plus 5 upon 7. This will be the same. Then minus plus is minus. So 3 minus 2 is 1 and sign of greater number. So 1 upon 4 plus 5 upon 7. Okay. Now again we have to equate the denominators. So 7 1 is 7 plus 5 4 is 20 and 4 multiplied by 7 is 28. So we will get 20 plus 7 is 27 upon 28. This is your LHS. Now we will solve for RHS. RHS will be A plus in the bracket B plus C. Okay. Substitute the values. Minus 1 upon 2 plus in the bracket 3 upon 4. Plus 5 upon 7. Okay. Here we will equate the denominators first. Minus 1 upon 2. This will be the same. Plus 7 3 is 21. Plus 5 4 is 20. Upon 28. Okay. Minus 1 upon 2. Plus what you will get here. 21 plus 20 is 41 upon 28 and now we will open the bracket. You will get minus 1 upon 2 plus 41 upon 28. So now here 2 is there, here 14 is there. So 2 14 is 28. So we will multiply here by 14 minus 14 upon 28 plus 41 upon 28. So now denominators are same. We will add the numerators. Minus plus is minus. So here you will get 41 minus 14 is 27 upon 28 and sign of greater number. So here positive sign will come. As you can see, both the numerators and denominators are same. Therefore, you get LHS equals to RHS. Hence verified. The third question says, write the additive inverse of the following rational numbers. So what is additive inverse? Additive inverse is any rational number when added with something gives zero. Okay. So that is its negative number. So 29 upon 24. So its additive inverse will be minus 29 upon 24. Okay. So for here, minus 9 upon minus 11. Here minus minus cancels out each other. So the number is 9 upon 11. And its additive inverse will be minus 9 upon 11. For the third question, 0 is there. So when 0 is added with, when 0 is added with 0, again we get 0. That is, we get additive identity. So additive inverse of 0 is 0 only. So the fourth question, 4 upon minus 15. So that is minus 4 upon 15. Okay. And its additive inverse will be 4 upon 15. Okay. Now we will do the fourth question. The fourth question is write the name of the property given below. The first question is 2 upon 5 plus 3 upon 10 equals to 3 upon 10 plus 2 upon 5. So here you can see the two numbers are just interchanged. That is, order of adding is different. So this is commutative property. Second question is minus 11 upon 27 plus 5 upon 9 is added first, and then it is added with minus 5 upon 18, and here which is equals to minus 11 upon 25, this number which is added to the sum of these two numbers, 5 upon 9 plus minus 5 upon 18. So it is addition of three numbers with a different order, so it is associative property. The third question is 2 upon 3 plus minus 2 upon 3 equals to 0, and which is again equals to minus 2 upon 3 plus 2 upon 3. So here you can see one rational number is there. It is added with its inverse number to get as 0. So it is existence of additive inverse. So it is additive inverse. The fourth question is 3 plus 0 equals to 3, which is again equals to 0 plus 3. So here 3 is added with 0 to get the same number. So here additive identity is used. Okay. The fifth question is fill in the blanks. The first question is the rational number which is its own additive inverse is. You know the only rational number which is additive inverse, which is its own additive inverse is 0. That is 0 plus 0 is again 0. So your answer will be 0. Okay. Minus 23 upon 8 plus minus 9 equals to something plus minus 23 upon 8. So here you can see the two numbers are just same, and here addition is different. Order of addition is different. So here minus 9 will become. This is your commutative property. The third question is minus 7 upon 11 plus 13 upon 22 is added first, and its addition and its sum is added with 2 upon minus 5, which will be equals to something plus 13 upon 22 plus 2 upon minus 5. So this is associative property. So here this number will come as it is missing, minus 7 upon 11. The fourth question is 16 upon 31 plus something equals to 0 plus 16 upon 31, which is again equals to 16 upon 31. So here you can see any rational number is added with something to get the same rational number. So it is additive identity. So here 0 will come. Okay. 3 upon 4 plus minus 3 upon 4 equals to 0, which is equals to something plus 3 upon 4. So it is additive inverse. So here minus 3 upon 4 will come. With this we complete with our second exercise also. In the next video we will start with a subtraction of rational numbers and its properties. Till then, practice the first and two exercises thoroughly.